Hey guys, it's Mickey, and I'm here with Tim Richardson, and we're at the Show Me Reptile Show here in St. Louis, and gonna ask Tim some questions about, you know, some of his animals that he has out and what he's working with. So Tim, how long have you been doing this? How long have you been messing with reptiles?
Almost 22 years now. I started vending shows with a lot of old timers like Bob Vico, Larry Hastings. I couldn't even drive. My mom would drop me off. And I would basically walk around a show like this and find somebody and move the table space off of them.
So not much has changed.
No, 22 years. I mean, there's still Leos and I'm still mooching table space, so.
All right, so let's talk about some of the stuff you have here on your table today.
Okay.
I've noticed that albino Colombian rainbow boa, that's super cool. You know, we've got some Brooks King snakes. These are pretty cool. You know, what's something that's specialty to you? I know you work with like these
so
weird geckos.
These spiny tail geckos. I specialize in a lot of Australian stuff. I do the Australian leaf tail geckos, the frilled dragons, the knob tails. So this is one that I produced myself. This is a little female Staphylus. They actually have a defense mechanism in their tail. When they feel threatened, they will curl their tail and actually squirt stuff out of it. It's more common with Staphylus tonicata, which is the golden spiny tail. But these guys here are a little more chill. And they come in quite a different colors and forms and shapes. There's a little Eastern female. And both these guys are almost full grown. We do some Australian monitors, which are pretty cool. We had some Ackies here, but unfortunately they're gone. We do breed high-end Tokays, and this guy here has actually gotten some Tokays from me, and he's the Tokay tamer.
He's tamed the vile beast.
He has. So we kind of pick little odd and end stuff that you never really see, and that's basically kind of what we like working with.
So somebody new, you know, you would suggest somebody new, you know, working with this, right? They just have to do a little bit of research and set them up properly, and they'd be good to go.
So everybody sees the price tag. This one's kind of high price because, I mean, she is a female. She will be ready to breed next year, but the babies are super easy. You do 12-12-18, which, you know, you can find them at every show. Exoterra, they do need UVB even though they are nocturnal, and the UVB actually puts out enough heat for them. On the bigger tanks, we do put puck lights, the mini halogen lights, to heat them.
Perfect.
So here's another really cool one that we work with. This is a Australian gecko. This is the velvet gecko, Odora monilis. So it's kind of another odd one that you don't get to see very often. And I think we work with about 50 different species of Australian geckos now, or just Australian animals in general.
So if somebody was going to come pick this animal up from you today, you're always available to walk them through like the care, husbandry and stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, phone, you could call me any day. Anytime, really. My phone's always on me.
Because we're really about educating and showing people how easy these animals actually are to keep. Because I feel like a lot of people are intimidated, or, you know, there's just bad information out there about keeping reptiles.
Especially with Australian. I mean, everybody's like, oh, I'm going to kill that. And I'm like, they're really super easy.
Yeah. Yeah, you get started on the right path, and you're
exactly.
good to go.
Now, Australia does have a lot of different climates. So, I mean, you kind of got to do a little bit of research and figure out whether it's tropical, desert, semi-arid.
Yeah, but it's just like people think everything from Africa lives in the desert.
You can always pick my brain and ask me the questions, and I can basically answer all your questions off the top of my head.
Oh, beautiful. Well, thanks, Tim.
Appreciate it. All right, thank you.